Right. So let's start with Purva Falguni. And we will go with the same way, the mantra for Purva Falguni, the stories for Purva Falguni, the remedies for Purva Falguni, and the result of different padas of Purva Falguni. Right. Now tell me one very particular thing. There are three nakshatras, and by the division six, which are divided into two parts, right? Purva Falguni, Uttara Falguni, Purva Shada, Uttara Shada, Purva Bhadra, Uttara Bhadra, right? What is this particular thing? Why it is Purva and Uttara? Why it is before and after? No idea. Purva and Uttara, these nakshatras are like, you know, whenever it is one Purva nakshatra and one Uttara nakshatra, it is generally one complete nakshatra, which for the sake of division is divided into two. Logically, astronomically speaking. If speaking by with the aspect of prediction, Purva means something that have happened before, more related to the past life karmas. And Uttara is something that is yet to come, something that you still have to achieve. This is what I generally do. Whenever in a Prashna or in a natal chart, if there is a planet in any Purva Nakshatra, right? Purva Falguni, Purva Shada, Purva Bhadra. Then you have done multiple karmas related to that planet, related to the signification of that planet, related to the houses owned by that planet in previous lives. And now you have to go through those results. Whereas the planet in Uttara Nakshatras, Uttara Falguni, Uttara Shada, Uttara Bhadra, does indicate that you have done almost very negligible karma in the field of those planets, and there is a long opportunity. You have high level of free will regarding those planets where you can work. Understood my point? Everything in astrology is very much symbolical. I think I have talked about this particular aspect before as well. That is yath pinde tat brahmande, right? Whatever is in outward is inward. So, have you noticed it? Sun will go through the 12 signs in an year. That makes circle 1. And moon will go through the 27 signs in a month. That will make the circle 2. But then you cannot say that sun will not go through the 12 signs in a month. So the 12 sign circle of year also comes in month. And 27 nakshatra month also goes to the year. So the sun's movement through the 12 signs every month, where do you find that? You find that in D12 chart, Dwadashamsha. And I will just tell you a very small off-topic technique. Check the Rashi of any planet in D12, Dwadashamsha. And, you know, whenever the planet transits through that sign, or whenever the sun transits through that sign, you will get to face the most important karma related to that planet in that particular year. Sorry, in that particular month. That is how it works. Got my point? Understood. This thing is crucial. This thing is important. This is when you go on to realize the particular karma. Getting my point? So sun passing through all the 12 signs, as I told you, na yat pinteto brahmande, there's a circle inside the circle, the infinite circles, right? So yat pinteto brahmande, the sun going through the 12 signs in a month happens in D12, right? Because D12 will have all the 12 signs. And moon going through the 27 nakshatras expanded over, are also expanded over an year, right? And this particular thing, you must be thinking that why I'm wasting your time. Still, this particular understanding is very important. Right. This thing is something that needs to be understood. This Purva and Uttara set of nakshatras indicate a particular point in the year. And things before that point and things after that point, you need to understand. And you know, there are Hindu months also, right? Chait, Vaisakh, Jeth, Ashadh, etc. And these, how we get these names? We get these names by the star when moon gets the Purnima. Right? So January is called Magh, because moon will get Purnima into Magha Nakshatra. Moon will get Purnima in Leo, which means sun is supposed to be in Aquarius, right? So Uttara Falguni and Purva Falguni, we are going to know about Purva Falguni. Which month is Phagun? What is in Phagun? What is important with Phagun? Holi. Phagun is holy. So Purva Falguni is before holy and after holy. So what is there before holy and what is there after holy? You haven't, I made a video for my Hindi channel, Hola Ashtak. Have you gone through that? In that video, I have specifically talked about that 8 days before holy is known as Hola Ashtak, and in those Hola Ashtak days, anything auspicious is prohibited. Good is not, auspicious is prohibited. Right. So you can join a job, but you cannot marry. Auspicious things cannot be done. Regular things, new, can be done. Okay. So that is what comes in Purva Falguni. It is the time before Holi and the 8 days of holastak when doing any new thing is prohibited. That does mean that any planet in Purva Falguni, you are going to face unnecessary hurdles when you are going to do auspicious things related to that particular planet. For this particular reason, Mars is very bad in Purva Falguni because it will obstruct marriage. Mangal by the name means all auspicious works. When Mars is powerful, any auspicious thing that you undertake will go very smoothly. There are many people, right, when they try to do havan, when they try to do puja, something or the other will go wrong. It is an indicative of bad Mars. One of the best remedies for Mars is to do auspicious things in your home, puja at least a month, at least once a month, etc. Getting my point? So that's why Mars in Purva Falguni is considered very bad. That is terrible. Getting my point? Mars in Purva Falguni is terrible. It will tend to obstruct every auspicious thing. And leaving that aside, if there is any other planet in Purva Falguni related to the signification of that planet, there will be multiple obstructions and hurdles. So if you have Venus in Purva Falguni, marriage can be an issue. If you have Mercury in Purva Falguni, the admission in college can be an issue. If you have Jupiter in Purva Falguni, finding a guru can be an issue. Getting into spirituality can be an issue. If you have Sun in Purva Falguni, then you know the childbirth may be very inauspicious. Your child may be born at a very bad day. Right? Sun indicates the continuation of lineage. Sun indicates the Pitrus, right? So you will become a Pitru once you get a child. Moon indicates inauspiciousness and undertakings. Moon is the karka for everything that you do with your ichcha, everything that you do with desire. Like, we have desires, right? You know what? 2-3 days ago, I was having desire that I should give money to some goshala. It's just a desire coming out of my mind, right? That is a desire, right? And I will want to complete that desire. I want to fulfill that desire, right? That is what moon indicates. And when moon is in Purva Falguni, your desire doesn't get completed without obstruction, right? Purva Falguni comes up with a whole lot of obstruction. Do you get my point? Right? That's what Purva Falguni is. We have completed all planets. Anyone left? Saturn. You should know that Saturn is particularly a very important. You know, because Saturn does indicate coming of people into your life. Right? Saturn indicate coming of people into your life. That is something that needs to be understood. So when Saturn is in Purva Falguni, right person is not coming to you at the right time. So, you know, Saturn in Purva Falguni generally, I will say that this is a person after 3 years of marriage, he will come to find that the another prospect which I haven't chosen for marriage was actually the right one and not the one that I have actually chosen, right? So Saturn comes with the aspect of, you know, people coming to your life. That is what Saturn does. Okay. Rahu will indicate any auspicious things that is done by digging, such as making a home, etc., laying a foundation for anything. And Ketu will indicate auspicious things related to flying, travels, etc. This is something related with Purva Falguni, that is what comes before Holi, and that is obstruction. There is one more aspect to it. Let me be very honest with you. There is one more aspect of it. What is that? What is the other thing that happens before Holi?
Shivratri.
Yes. Shivratri. Shivratri is also a very, but particularly speaking, there are few vratas that fall on extremely inauspicious days. And one of them is Shivratri. Let me tell you, if you ever think, na, today is this Vrat, let me do something new or something important, that is the worst decision that you can ever make in life. Getting my point? Because Vratas are the most inauspicious days. Sages have cleverly thought that these days are very bad. These people should only do puja, should not do anything else. When you ignore God to do something, that thing is going to perish. And you know, Shivratri, there is a mini Shivratri that is known as Pradosh. Pradosh comes every month. And when Pradosh comes in a particular month, it becomes Shivratri. Now Pradosh will be either Chaturdashi or either will be Amavasya. Triyodashi, Chaturdashi, Amavasya. And all these tithis are bad itself. Getting my point. So Purva Falguni also indicates something which is wrongly timed. If the lord of the profession is in Purva Falguni, it starts very early. If the lord of the education is in Purva Falguni, it starts very late. Right? Purva Falguni indicates something which is very wrongly timed. Right? You gotta do that thing under pressure. You're not doing it with your own desire or own wish or your own will. You are doing it under pressure. You're doing it because you have to. It is not a conscious willing decision. It is a forced decision. Right? And there is something good before Holi also, that is Vasant. Right. So that does indicate that, you know, leaving these hurdles aside, leaving this wrong time things aside, leaving the obstructions aside, people generally tend to enjoy the planets in Purva Falguni a lot. People tend to enjoy the planets in Purva Falguni a lot. So you know why there is a problem when Venus is in Purva Falguni, why there is a problem in marriage? Because you have enjoyed the particular result a lot. So now when it comes to the choice, you are confused. Whether to choose the prospect that your parents are telling you or choose the person you have been dating with since long. Right? So overuses leading to extinction. And that extinction making your decision difficult is something that is indicated by Purva Falguni. Okay? This is something that needs to be kept into mind. Just a general introduction, although I can give one such introduction for every nakshatra, but still let me hold it. We hold the horses for you. Like every nakshatra is at least one vrat. You should find it out. Which vrat is done in which nakshatra? Every tithi is related to avrat, every nakshatra is related to avrat, every day is related to avrat. That is very common. But which vrat? Which vrat you think is related to Bharani? Come on, the year will start from Ashwini. And by March, you will come to Purva Falguni. Now you do it yourself, right? What is the second thing that you will have in the start of any year? Although the year should start from Chaitra, by the way. But actually, the year will start from the sun's transit to Capricorn. From Makar Sankranti is equal to Ashwini. Take it clear. Sun went to work, right? Sun went to Capricorn, Makar Sankranti. Sun went to work, he produced a child. First work that he will do. Right? After, what happens after Makar Sankranti? What is the next thing that comes after Makar Sankranti? And is it related to Bharani? You think over it. This much knowledge about Indian philosophy and religions, etc., you should have if you want to be very serious into astrology. You cannot ignore Indian religion and learn astrology. I'm not saying that you should be into Indian religion, but at least study it. I'm not interested in mathematics at all, but for astrology, I have to. Right, for the basic calculations, right? I was very poor in mathematics at a point of time. But astrological mathematics, I know very well. Do you get my point? Do you understand? Are you with me, right? On the same plane. Going further, the shloka for Purva Falguni is Aryamanaha, Purva Falguni Jaya, Prastha Drishbho Avastar. Aryamanaha. Who is Aryama? Ayarma or Aryama, whatever you say. Who is Aryama? Aryaman. That is a form of sun. Aryama is a form of sun. But what does it... Okay, do you know that there are 10 forms of Vishnu? You know it wrong. There are 24 forms of Vishnu. 10 is like quite normal. Pradyumna, there is Dasha Avatar, there is View Avatar, and there are multiple things. So Vishnu have technically 24 avatars, right? And there are Ekadash Rudra, and out of that Ekadash Rudra, Hanuman is out. Right. So Shiva have a multiple avatars. So what about, you know, the Hindu religion goes with Panch Devata Pujan, right? Panchayatan. And one of that Panchayatan is Vishnu and Shiva, and one is Devi, and you know multiple avatars of Devi, right? And in that Panchayatan, there comes Ganesha and Surya. For Ganesha, you know, for those who are from like Mumbai belt, they know about multiple forms of Ganesha, right? The multiple forms of Ganesha are there. What about Surya? And what those different avatars do? Ram does a particular work, Krishna does a particular work. So Aryama is an avatar of sun, and what does Aryama do? Come on. Let me answer you something. After Makar Sankranti, there is Sakumbari Purnima. That is related to Bharani. Once all the sages were dying because there was nothing to eat in the world, then Devi came in the form of Sakumbari and gave all the plants and plantations and fruits and vegetables to sages to live. That is what Sakumbhari is related to Bharani. Everything is extinction. Everything is going. And after that, there is Sankast Chaturthi. Lambodar Sankast Chaturthi. That is related to Kritika. The list is long. What does Aryama do? What is the work of Aryama? One. Aryama means the close friend. Aryama. Aryama is Ari, enemy of Yama. Aryama is the one who saves you from Yama. Because Yama is coming to kill you, right? Yama is coming to kill everyone. And who's gonna save you? Aryama. That's why he is called the closest friend. Because he is a very close friend. He saves you when it is needed. That what comes from Purva Falguni. The planet of Purva Falguni is very dormant. He's not gonna save you until and unless the last time have came. I will tell you one particular thing. The planet of Purva Falguni, you will get the result of that planet. You will get the full good result of that planet once in life. But that will be life changing. That will be life saving. And at the last moment, it is Yama. He's not saving you from any disease or misery. He's saving you from death. So, you know, Aryama, taking a normal example, it indicates you being saved at the last moment. You're about to get married, all the complete marriage is finalized, everything is done. And just before the bride enters the marriage hall, someone comes and tells that the boy is of bad character. So saving at the last time, there's a remorse. There is a remorse, there's a sadness that will go with the cancelling of the function. But the last time saving, getting my point, the saving grace at the last moment is what is indicated by Ariyama and what is indicated by Purva. मैं नाम भूल जा रहा हूँ बार बार, लिखा हुआ है मैंने नीचे यहाँ पूर्वा बालकनी पढ़ाना. Multiple things running in my head right now. Getting my point? So this is one help. And you know what? This Purva Falguni is very much connected to, you know, the giving, you know, like life coming once again. So if the fifth lord or Mercury or Jupiter is in Purva Falguni, that at one point of time, the complete education is gone. And you have seen some people, right, who after working 40 years in the corporate job will start learning something new. That is what Purva Falguni is. Getting my point? When everything is lost, gone, you restart it. After a long break. Understood my point? So the sun is inauspicious in Purva Falguni. Why we are making this particular comment? Like, for what? Where have you read this particular thing that sun is bad in Purva Falguni?
You said just now, right, that it gives a inauspiciousness with respect to childbirth.
Generally speaking, like when we practice astrology, you will come to find one very particular thing, that the result total for planets and houses are not very accurate. The result for Mars in the fourth house will not come to pass that particular way, right? This is what generally happens. It is the first of all, primary classics, A grade primary classics are not, will not give such results, firstly. Primary A grade classic generally deals with formulas. And they tend not to give results. Like if you go to Grih Jatak, they haven't given the result of Lagna Lord in different houses. They've just given the result of Sun and Moon in different houses, and we just have given the result of Moon in different nakshatras without elaborating how to do it for other planets, just for the sake of example. Because any fixed rule is not gonna work primarily. Later time, text will elaborate more and more and more and more on this stuff. Right? And more the elaboration, less accurate the thing is. The first point, right? So, you know, when you go to Saravali or Grih Jatak, you will not see how to analyze a house. This particular chapter is completely missing. Sage is taking the clue that you have understood a particular thing and you are analyzing it now. But at later times, there will be books like this, you know, how to analyze a house. And they will say, if the seventh lord is in the seventh house, marital life will be very good. But you will see multiple horoscopes where the seventh lord is in the seventh house and marital life is not very good. And because once again, to tell seventh lord in the seventh house, then for all the 12 ascendants, for this lagna, if this is the seventh lord in this house, then it is okay, then it is not okay. If it is aspected by this planet, this is okay, this is not okay, etc. will make the thing very, very, very big, very lengthy. Just to tell the result of the seventh lord in 12 houses in connection to 9 planets, aspected by 9 planets under 12, under 9 navamshas, will be very difficult and very big. Generally, what sages do, they don't give such results. They will just give you understanding, the first important stuff. Secondly, classics don't deal with what is the result of planet in nakshatras. Generally, other astrologers, based on their own intelligence, for an example, there was a book, Jyotish Kaumudi, Vairagunandan Prasad or someone, I just forgot the name. There was a book, Jyotish Kaumudi, where the result of different planets in different nakshatras aspected by different planets was given. Right. Now they go with the logic of Magha is ruled by Ketu and Purva Falguni is ruled by Venus. Now Venus is not good for Sun because Venus is in the Saturn department. Venus is the friend of Saturn. So Sun in Purva Falguni is not supposed to give good results. Specifically, it will not give good result related to child because Venus is the sperm and Sun is the fire. So it will dry up the sperm and child, they will be unable to produce the children. But such results are highly erroneous and will not, in real life practice, we will not see them actually coming out in practice. So when we comparatively analyze it over 100 horoscopes, you will find that they matching the real result is only 20, 30, 40%, not more. So we cannot just specify that a particular planet, like I will just give an example. This is a very, very good thing. And this is why I don't categorize. See, we say that fourth house Saturn is bad. In old age, it will give you misery. This is what we generally say. But as an astrologer, when I see Saturn in the fourth house, I don't make a comment. Even if someone will say, sir, Saturn is bad in the fourth house, I will say every planet is bad everywhere. You don't worry. Why? Because once I see Saturn in the fourth house, then I have to see in which Rashi it is, first of all. If it is an Aquarius or Libra or Capricorn, then it is okay. Even in the fourth house, it is not bad primarily. Even if it is not in these three signs, if it is in a bad sign, then I will go and check the Navamsha if it is in a good Navamsha or not. If it is in a good Navamsha, I will say good result. If not good Navamsha, I will say bad result. After that, even in the sign, I will then go and check the Ashtaka Varga. If the, like, you know, Saturn in fourth house is told will give misery in old age. Now, 50% of the chart, it will not give misery in the old age. 50% of the chart, it will give misery in the old age. So the complete formula is Saturn in the fourth house and in the Ashtaka Varga of Saturn, there have to be less than 4 points in the fourth house. Why Ashtaka Varga? Because we are looking at support. Ashtaka Varga is one planet being supported by eight other planets. So Ashtaka Varga, are your children supporting you or not? If Ashtaka Varga is good, still Saturn in the fourth house, then person is having misery in his old age because of his own reason. His children are telling him, come to Delhi. He's like, no, I will live in hometown only. He is miserable because of his own condition. Not supported by Ashtaka Varga, in that scenario, his children may leave him. Not care about it. So this is a particular thing. We should not be taking this particular thing that Sun is bad in Purva Falguni. The planet is not supposed to be bad. I will tell you one particular thing. The planet is either going to support the house or the Rashi or the Nakshatra or not going to support the house or the Rashi or the Nakshatra. Primarily, first point, if I see Sun in Purva Falguni, I will take the significations of Purva Falguni and Sun is there, Sun is a malefic. I will say Sun will tend to obstruct these particular things. So obstruction that I have told in the starting that Purva Falguni gives obstruction, that obstruction will be enhanced because of Sun. So rather than saying it will not give child, I will say it will create a problem in acquiring the child at the right time, but after some hurdle, the person may or may not get the child depending on how the fifth lord is. Because once again, when we come to astrology, we are very clear with where to look at. Now I will talk about this particular thing, like switching off the recording because it will go very long, but I specifically want to answer this particular thing. This is what we will do first of all. Purva Falguni indicates these things and Sun being a malefic in Purva Falguni, these significations go bad, point one. It does indicate children in a sense because Mitra indicates Aryaman indicates the one you get married to. Aryaman indicates the best friend of the bride. It is bad for marriage, yeah. So it indicates marriage. Sun is a malefic, goes to Purva Falguni. In marriage matters, Sun is going to create problem because he is a malefic. Now that will be very problematic if the Sun is the 6th, 8th or 12th lord. But if the Sun is the Lagna lord, that is just initial obstruction and after that obstruction, everything is okay. So we are supposed to do this particular, a lengthy type of analysis rather than just jumping. Try and understand this. One planet in 10th house will have good profession. We should never judge this particular thing. We should not do. We have to see a complete, when we go to a chart reading, there will be a complete set of things. And then we have to be attentive to every factor. like sun in the 10th house will make someone employed in government. General result. Sun in the 10th house, sun indicates king, someone working for the king. Now in 80% chart where sun is in the 10th house, you will not see person working in government. That particularly works, right? Exalted sun in the 10th house should surely make you work in the government. But I know a horoscope where there is exalted sun in the 10th house and the sun is the second lord and the person is not working in government. He's the second lord, right? So second lord in 10th house powerful just indicate that this person is going to earn a whole lot of money from the profession, but will not indicate that he will be in a government profession. Why? Because Raj Yogas are not there. So sun in the 10th house indicating a high level government position will only be given when there is a strong Raj Yoga. Otherwise, no.
चार्ट में नहीं है ऐसे जस्ट क्वेश्चन आए
कमिंग बैक टू द सिग्निफिकेशंस ऑफ पूर्वा फाल्गुनी इट डज इंडिकेट बीइंग सेव्ड एट द लास्ट मोमेंट राइट बिकॉज अर्यमा इज योर क्लोजेस्ट फ्रेंड द नेक्स्ट इज अर्यमनः पूर्वा फाल्गुनी अर्ली रेडिश The starting part of Purva Falguni is red in complexion. And early reddishness indicate the phenomena of sunrise. So whichever planet is in Purva Falguni, the results of that planets are just starting to, as I have already told you, right, this is a Purva Nakshatra. This is a Purva Nakshatra, that means the result of the planet you have already, the karma of the planet you have already started doing in your previous life, right? This is something that I have already explained. Now adding one deeper point into it, because Purva Falguni is early reddish, the result of the planets in Purva Falguni, the karma related to the planet in Purva Falguni, you haven't started very early. You have just started it sometimes ago. So it is not like that you have realized everything. See, this particular thing indicates how much mature you are in. So say if the Venus is in Purva Falguni or say Sun is in Purva Falguni, then in that scenario, because you have just started working with the signification of that planet, the level of maturity that one needs for spiritual development, the level of maturity that one needs for political movement, the level of maturity that one will need for other significations of sun may not be present there, and the person will face a challenge to develop that. Like if we take Ketu for spirituality, if Ketu is in Purva Falguni in that scenario, the person may not be, getting my point? The person may not be very much well versed in how spirituality works, etc. The person have already started working in the path of spirituality and he is closely coming to different encounters on the particular path, but he's not very well versed on how to handle things, right? Planet in Purva Falguni are very much like a child who have just started playing football. So he know the rules of football, but the practical experience he's not having. And over the different events in his life, he will keep on getting those particular things, right? Every failure, every success will be a new learning regarding the signification of the planet who is in Purva Falguni. So when it is Venus, it is marriage. When it is Mercury, it is for education. When it is the ninth lord, it is in the case of fortune. And whenever I say the result for fortune, you take it the result for taking decisions, getting my point. How do you interpret this particular thing, the good result for fortune or person learning in the matters of fortune? How do you interpret it? Suppose you first started a business only with money. You were like, I have money, I will start a business. Okay. It failed. The next learning is you came to know that money is not important only. You also need to check the market trend. Then you took money, you also saw the market trend, but somehow your business once again failed. So third time you went with money, you knew the market trend, and this time you also had public support. Getting my point? So this type of consecutive improvement in your decisions is something indicated by ninth house, which we refer as the improvement in fortune. And modifying a particular thing over the time is something that will make you, right? Aryamanah Purva Falguni Jaya. Jaya the word itself means wife, right? The seventh house is called Jaya Bhav. So once again, after Ashwini, Purva Falguni is the next nakshatra, which is very important for marital life. So if there is a malefic in Purva Falguni, marital life is quite disturbed. If there is a benefic in Purva Falguni, marital life is okay. Planet in Purva Falguni indicates how your marital life is. First of all, if there is no planet in Purva Falguni, there is nothing good or bad in marital life, point one. Nothing significant to say. If there is no planet in a particular nakshatra, there is nothing significant related to the signification of that planet, right? Nothing significant. When there is a planet, then there is something significant. If it is a good planet, something significant in a good way. If it is a bad planet, something significant in a bad way. So by the uses of the word Jaya, it means that Purva Falguni is connected to marriage and marital matters. So any planet in Purva Falguni, keep a check on the signification of that particular planet regarding your marriage. Like Mars in Purva Falguni, keep a check over your anger. Mercury in Purva Falguni, keep your, keep your academic interest separate from your marriage, because that may disturb it. Right? Anything can create a disturbance anywhere. Right? Jaya means the one who is bring forth. What is, see, Jaya means wife, Patni means wife, etc. But what is the difference between Patni and Jaya? Right? What is the meaning of the word Patni?
Jaya, I think, is the one who gives birth. Wife who gives children. No?
I'm Rajita ji, I'm specifically talking about the meaning of the word. The one who gives birth to child is known as Dhatri.
Dhatri.
The one who bears the child in her stomach. Dhatri. Dharan jo karti hai. That's why Earth is called Dhatri, because she bears us. Dhatri is once again a synonym for wife. Patni, the one who will help you control senses is Patni. Patni, right? The one who will help you control the senses, help you live a life. Like helping you 50-50. Tu marega, main kaatega. That is Patni. Jaya is the one who you have to win over, or who wins over you. Jaya. Jaya comes from the word Jaya. So the one who won over your heart is Jaya, or the one whose heart you won is Jaya. But talking with the perspective of Aryama, Jaya means the lady who was bring forth. Jaya is the lady who was brought only for you. To bring forth this particular thing indicates that whichever planet is in Purva Falguni, related to the signification of that particular planet, you have to be careful, because there are chances that you will be pushed and forced to become a leader regarding the signification of that planet. Useless responsibility. And if you want to go to the path of that planet, if you want to follow the path of that planet, then you have to ekla chalo re. Then you have to go particularly alone. So Venus in Purva Falguni, the person may not want to get married, but he will be burdened with the responsibility of getting married, because there are multiple other things that he cannot control and which can only be solved by the person getting married. Bachcha daru bita shaadi karo. Any? आपकी जिम्मेदारी है बेवड़े को दारू चढ़ाना. आप बीवी नहीं, आप हो भाई नशा मुक्ति केंद्र. सो दिस इज व्हाट पूर्वा वाल्मीकि डज, राइट? रिगार्डिंग द सिग्निफिकेशन ऑफ नॉर्मल प्लैनेट्स, इफ देयर इज अ 10th लॉर्ड इन पूर्वा वाल्मीकि, देन यू आर द वन हु हैव टू टेक द रिस्पांसिबिलिटी ऑफ योर प्रोफेशन. You are the one who is the leader in your profession. So generally the 10th lord in Purva Falguni does indicate someone, right? Purva Falguni indicates the one who is particularly a leader. And whenever I say the word leader, try understanding it in two senses. should I do something? Should I tell you the real crux of the course? Purva Falguni, for the matter, Purva Falguni is a Akul Nakshatra. And Rohini was a Kula Nakshatra. I told you this particular thing regarding Rohini also. I am telling you this particular thing regarding Purva Falguni also. One is Akula Nakshatra, Rohini. And Purva Falguni is Akula Nakshatra. So what is the difference if you are born in a Kula Nakshatra or you are born in a Akula Nakshatra? If you are born in a Kula Nakshatra, then you can only go to the extent of your father. If you are born in Akul Nakshatra, then you will surpass everyone in your family. Getting my point? So this is something. And there is Kulakul Nakshatra, that is a mix. In some matters, normal, some matters exceed. So like I am born in Kulakul Nakshatra, suppose. Then my finance can be equal to everyone in the family, whereas my fame can be very much. Getting my point? Or my fame can be as everyone in the family, but my finance can be very much. Do you get my point? In Rohini also, I told you this particular thing, that Rohini indicates someone who is making a new field. Rohini indicates someone who is making a new field. If the 10th Lord is in Rohini, then this person made a new field, right? Someone started Zomato, someone started Amazon, everyone starts with one idea or the other idea, getting a point. And people have started idea everywhere at every places, right? A new idea, at least someone implements an idea, then people copy it, right? Like my guru have placed the idea of how can you predict things from a Rashi only, and then people copied it. So there is someone who plants the thing, right? So this is, you know, you start something new. That goes with both Rohini as well as Purva Falguni. But Rohini is a Kula Nakshatra and Purva Falguni is a Akula Nakshatra. And what is the difference? When it is a Kula Nakshatra, you can only start a sub-branch. You cannot start a complete branch. You can just start a sub-branch out of it, right? Whereas that is indicated by Rohini. Whereas Purva Falguni is Akula Nakshatra. That indicates you are going to start something completely new. Not a sub-branch, but completely new. Getting my point? If someone does a new researches in mundane astrology, then what he's doing? Sub-branch of astrology. Now he's doing something new in a sub-branch of astrology. But if someone comes up with a brand new method of chart analysis, then what he's doing? Is doing Purva Falguni thing, right? Completely new. It is just a new method of analysis itself, right? It is not a sub-branch. Like KP, Krishnamurti Paddhati, is a sub-branch of stellar astrology, right? Just a sub-branch of it. It is not a completely new thing. Getting my point? That is. Aryamanaha Purva Falguni Jaya Parastad Shibo Avastad. Drishibho means a male animal. Drishibho or Vrishibho, any can be the word. It is, I haven't written it very clearly. Sometimes when I write something, my own handwriting become something that I myself cannot read. For some other reason, maybe God wanted me to become a doctor. So I write that particular way. Leaving it aside. Purva Falguni indicates a male animal, which means that the zeal and the power of Purva Falguni is very high. Male animals means an untiring devotion, untired working. What do I mean by this? Because, you know, there is a substance of male and female in complete astrology. Male planet, female planet, you know. So what is this male animal? And what is this female animal? Taurus is a bull. Bull is, he's not a cow. Come on. It can be cow also. if the figure of Taurus makes, if the stars of Taurus make a particular figure, why they are saying that it is a bull? Why it is not a cow? Or why it is not a buffalo? But it can be anything. आसमान में कलर थोड़ी ना है भाई, काउ बफेलो कुछ भी हो जाता. Why it is bull only? There are no colors in the sky. Even the image is also not clear. If you see the sky right now, आपको कोई बैल दौड़ता थोड़ी दिख रहा है. You can only see a few stars and connecting them, you will get a rough sketch. There is no color in the sketch. There is no outline, underline, nothing is there, right? So why they have said that it is a male animal? Why they have said that this is a bull? Aries is a ram. Why it is not a goat? Why it is not a female animal? Why it is a male animal? Kanya is female, right? Virgo is female. Why she is not a male? Aquarius is a male holding a pitcher. Why it is not a woman holding a pitcher? What does this particular male thing is there? Let me tell you one very particular thing. Regarding female planets and regarding female things, it is one at a time. You check one particular thing. If Venus, or Venus will rule two houses for your chart, right? Two houses. If one house is getting activated, the other house will be dormant. Or if there is a result of one house, then the result of the other house will not be there. If signification of one house is activated, the result of the other house will not be activated. And there will be three houses. Those of you who follow me, you know I do multiplied by three. Why multiplied by three? Because he can keep up all the three results where he is placed in the two rashis that he owns, right? So if Venus is lord of the fourth house, ninth house, situated in the 10th house, then when you make fourth house, when you are in the process of making a property, at the time your luck is not supporting you, and you are not progressing in your profession. Only one thing is activated. Getting my point? When your luck is on the rise, then neither you are able to make home, neither you are able to progress in your profession. You are just getting lucky. Earning money, not increasing in profession. And when you are getting fame, then neither you are being lucky nor you are making thing, right? So fourth house is there. So when you are getting famous or when you are getting lucky, you always have a mental tension because the fourth house solace is not there. That is not being activated at the same point of time. Do you get me? Female. You know one particular thing. When you get the good result of the sign of the house where Cancer is placed, you will get the bad result of Moon. When you get the good result of Moon, you will get bad result related to the house where Cancer is placed. Female can activate one thing at a time. Getting my point? That's why all the nakshatras are known as female. Only one signification of a planet for the time being will be activated. So if Shravan gives you money, it will not give you good words. It will give you bad words and money. If it gives you something good to hear, then he will not give you money. Getting my point? So when it is a female thing, one thing activated at a time. When it is a male thing, multiple things are activated at a given point of time. Right? Get me? This is a good result, this is a bad result, both. If sun is bad, then the bad result of the Rashi where he is placed is there, and also the bad result of Leo is there. Whereas if Moon is bad, then only the result of Moon is bad. Getting my point? So if Moon is the lord of the 10th house situated in the 9th house, your father is good, so profession is not there. If your profession is good, then father is not there. Getting my point? One thing activated at a point of time. It can be good, it can be bad also. Write this thing very carefully. Getting my word? Write this thing very carefully. This is very important. Two planets in Cancer, one activated at a point of time. Both not activated. The conjunction in Cancer is very bad, is not very useful. You will see Moon and Ketu in Cancer. Why this person is getting good result of Moon? Why Ketu is not afflicting? Female sign, one activated at a point of time. But when Ketu will be activated, Moon will not be able to save. It's one at a time. Getting my point? this female. Female does indicate low power. Getting my point or not? It indicates low power. Okay.
सर मर्क्यूरी और सैटर्न फिर किस तरह से देंगे रिजल्ट मेल और फीमेल के कंसर्न में आप बता रहे थे जो
मेल और फीमेल देखिए मैम सैटर्न को पुरुष नपुंसक और मर्क्यूरी को स्त्री नपुंसक बोला है ना तो सैटर्न इज अ मेल यूनिट एंड मर्क्यूरी इज अ फीमेल यूनिट Why Saturn is both Saturn mula trigona sign Aquarius male, Mercury mula trigona sign Virgo female. So this was how easy. Generally, the gender of Mercury and Saturn is decided based on the sign they are placed in. One small thing of record. So we just discussed about the. What is the signification of male animal? And there was a particular question on how to decide when which aspect will be activated. That is a very in-depth topic. And it is quite a serious question. And I have been dealing this question in the course. And as you must be knowing that this is a part of course, right? So I have dealt with this particular topic of when this nakshatra will be activated in the course. And that's a course content actually, right? And in future, I will try making a video on this activation of nakshatra as well. For now, let me leave this question unanswered. Going to the stories of Urva Falguni, as I told you, Aryama means Ari plus Yama, the one who is the enemy of Yama. So Aryama is in the duty of controlling the enemies. So generally, now quickly telling you because we have to end with the class and we have already been going extensive. So any planet in Aryama, you are not going to face many obstacles related to the signification of that planet from the outer world, right? So there, as I told you, there will be obstructions in accomplishing the significations of the planet which is in Purva Falguni. But still that obstruction is not from the external world or that obstruction is not from other people. That obstruction is because of your own flaws only. Right? Point one. And Aryama is, you know, the father who gives their daughter for donation is also known as Aryama. That Kanyadan, the father who does the Kanyadan is also known as Aryama. So one of the remedy for Purva Falguni will be to either do the Kanyadan or help a father in doing Kanyadan in a good way, right? So giving things in marriage ceremony is something that can work as a remedy for Purva Falguni. In the predictive aspect, it does indicate that whichever planet is in Purva Falguni, you will have to leave at least one major aspect of that planet. So if Venus is in Purva Falguni, either you have to leave luxuries or you have to leave comfort or you have to leave marriage, right? At least one thing you have to leave for your betterment only, right? It is not the betterment for anyone else, right? And Purva Falguni also indicates enlightenment. So whichever planet is in Purva Falguni, you are going to get enlightened related to the signification of that planet. You are going to get good knowledge related to the signification of that planet. So when it is Mars, there is good knowledge of warfare. There is good knowledge of tactics, etc. Bhaga. So that is for Aryama. A few stories related to it. Now coming to remedies, I have told you two remedies. Sorry, I have told you one remedy already, right? That is the Kanyadan one. And generally I give you three remedies. So let me give you two more remedies. Okay. So we came to know that Aryama is friend. Aryama is a friend who saves you from death. One major remedy is to donate things to people who are about to die. Donating things to people who are about to die, suffering from chronic disease, etc. Donating things to those people. I have given one remedy in Ganga Sadhak webinar that we did. And I have got very good feedback for this one. Sorry, I forgot to post that feedback. Generally, I get many feedbacks per day and I don't post it publicly. Many times I do, many times I don't. So, in Ganga Sadhak webinar, I told that if you see even a dead animal, go to a nearby shop, purchase some clothes for that animal, coffin, and, put that clothes over that particular animal. It's the remedy that I taught in Ganga Sadhak. It is for your better passage, so that when you die, your body is not, your body is not, your body get good care when you die. It is a remedy that was recommended by Ganga Sadhak. This is something that Ganga Sadhak used to do. Ganga Sadhak was a person that I knew closely. He was a great yogi, right? And Ganga Sadhak webinar is a remedy of that person. So he was a yogi having a material life, and he was quite successful in his material life. Not like those yogis who are a failure in their material life. He was a yogi who was also successful in his material life. Right. So that is the second thing, that whenever you see a dead animal, cover them with a cloth. Go to the nearest shop, purchase a cloth. And that is the second remedy for Aryama. And for all the nakshatras which are owned by Surya. For an example, Aryama. Aryama is a form of sun, as I told you in the starting. For sun, I will give you four remedies. And these four remedies you can use for every nakshatra which is lauded by one avatar of Surya. Remedy number one, Surya Argha. Wake up early in the morning and give water to sun god. The method of giving water is, you take a copper bowl or bowl made up of some metal. Okay. And by metal, it should not be iron or alloy or steel. So either gold or silver or brass or copper you can take. And have it up to the level of your navel. Have it on the level of your navel. And then pour water into it. The water that you give for Suri Argha should not touch any part below your waist. So that is the first thing. But Suri Argha you can only do between 6 a.m. to 8. By max 9. Not after that. So that is the first remedy for sun. The second remedy for sun, and this is one of the very powerful remedy, is every day light a diya. Every day light a diya, I think you people understand, right? Every day light a lamp. And almost in every tradition, there is a, in every religion, there is a tradition of lighting things, whether it is a lighting candle or lighting a diya, etc. Right? So at least lighting one candle or one diya every day should be into your duty, right? If you are traveling somewhere, go to a nearby temple and light a diya there. Right? But lighting a diya on every day is a good remedy for sun, as sun indicates fire tattva. And the lord of sun is also fire. Right? There is a very powerful mantra for sun given in Garuda Purana. Om Khakolkai Thah Thah. Okay? You can also chant this mantra 108 times every day for the remedy of the sun, the third remedy. You will find this in Garuda Purana easily. And the fourth remedy is you can either read Aditya Hriday Stotram or 108 names of Surya, or there are multiple stotras for Surya that you can also read. Right. Aditya Hriday Stotram is very good for winning over enemies, court cases, legal battle, etc. चाक्षुषो उपनिषद फॉर द प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू साइट, प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू प्लानिंग, इफ द थिंग्स आर नॉट गोइंग एज यूर प्लानिंग, if you are not able to succeed in your profession, if you are not able to judge people, if people deceive you, if people cheat you, then Chakshushopanishad, chanting that Chakshushopanishad will be beneficial. For all the common and normal remedies of the Surya, 108 names of Surya. Surya Ashtottara Shatanam. Ashtottara Shatanam means, Ashtottara Shat means 8 plus 100. So 108. Surya Ashtottara Shatanam, 108 names of Surya is recommended. Okay? A few remedies for sun that will be applicable for all the nakshatras which are ruled by any of the avatara of the sun. Now coming to the result for the different padas of Purva Falguni. Purva Falguni Padavan. Vargottam. Right? Leo Rashi, Leo Navamsha. Vargottam gives you three things for sure. Fame, guaranteed. Professional success, guaranteed. And good money, income, guaranteed. These three things are guaranteed. Right? So this is the first result for the Vargottam planet. That is, this is the first result for the first pada of Purva Falguni. Along with that, Purva Falguni first pada may create problems related to ego because the sun is very strong. Sun Rashi, Sun Navamsha, sun is very strong. There can be problem related to ego. There can be problems related to bone. There can be problems from wounds. There can be problems from attack. And specifically, sun indicates getting attacked by four-footed animals. Dogs, cats, etc. So you have to be careful regarding this particular thing. Right, Purva Falguni first pada also indicates that the person will be the first one to give child in their family, or their child will be the most affluent in all the children of the family. Right, along with this sun, the Purva Falguni first pada, I will not refer sun again and again, it will become confusing. Purva Falguni first pada also indicates someone who is a leader, who implements new thing in their family, new things in their business. Their marriage is generally unorthodox. Either they marry in the same family, if it is allowed, or if or they marry a known of their parents, right? So maybe the parents of your wife are friends of your own parents, is indicated by Purva Falguni first pada. Along with that, the lady, the wife of Purva Falguni first pada, will be a complete homemaker, will be a good homemaker. There can be some ego tussles, there can be some fights in marital life. Specifically, the wife in Purva Falguni first pada doesn't meet up to your standard. The wife in Purva Falguni first pada is very unfit for your profession. The spouse is very unfit for your profession. Purva Falguni first pada. Generally, the marital life is disturbed. There is very few children. Regarding siblings, this person will generally be the eldest one. In few cases, this will be the youngest one. Middle child, he will never be. If he is the middle child, then his growth is very restricted. Then he will not be able to grow in life. Right? Purva Falguni first pada, always cut your nails very regularly and never shave on Sunday. See, one particular thing, let me tell you. Chaur Karma, whichever planet you want to save in your chart, never cut your hair and nails on that particular day. Chaur Karma on the day of the planet, Chaur Karma is cutting off the nails and hair, makes that particular planet weak. Okay? That is for the first pada of Purva Falguni. The result given is the person will have a bell-shaped hair, bell-shaped face. So the upper portion will be narrow and the cheeks will be broad, right? So that is the bell-shaped face. The person will have a few hair, indicative of sun. Right, he will have very beautiful nose and eyes. He will have a hairy body, long pot belly. He will be fierce, and he will be fierce. And his when he will talk, his teeth will not be visible. Generally, will have disfigured teeth. And he will have strong and broad cheek, and strong and broad shoulders as well. Right, Purva Falguni first pada. Purva Falguni second pada, once again bad for marriage, good for money. one of the most loved children in their family. Generally, problems related to chest, veins, and other nervous systems based disease will be there. The person is very fierce and original in their ideas, very good in speaking, but generally makes small mistakes, right? This person is not, this person is someone who is intelligent, but at the same point of time will do silly mistakes, generally indicates the person who will make his superiors angry because of no known reasons, right? So if Venus is there, you make superior ladies angry, right? So interpret it this particular way. And along with this, yeah, it is good for money. The person is prominent in his family, loved by his family members, generally will be interested in investing money, will be blessed in the matters of finances, and their money, their thinking on money, their perspective on money is very unique. They will be fortunate in terms of this particular thing. Their elder child, will go to much heights. Right, their first relationship or first marriage is very difficult. Generally, all the marriages are very difficult. It is very good if you marry late for Purva Falguni second pada. Right, and this particular thing. Right, the person of Purva Falguni second pada will have limited hair on his body, not very much. Right, he will have large eyes, generally white, and he will be tall, dark, handsome, loved by woman, will be in multiple affairs, will be skilled, will be in some form of art, etc. Right, will be learned, and will be jumping from one work to another. Will not be able to live life peacefully. There will be one or the other disturbances always. And the steadiness in life will not complete very easily. And generally, the person will make very immature decisions which will lead him in trouble. Got it? Coming to Purva Falguni, third pada, the authority is challenged. No matter in which position the person is, at least once in their professional career, they will have to leave their position because of their family or because of disgrace. Disgrace is something that is like binded to your personality, right? And not very good for marital life. The person will have to live a very struggled life. The person will struggle a lot. Right, the health is a challenge. Life will be difficult. Generally, such people are like, you know, the longevity is not very good. It's generally what I'm supposed to say. Right? But don't judge longevity so easily. Longevity is a complex stuff. Marital life is not good. Life is hardworking. Either the person is the eldest in the family or youngest in the family. The person is generally in working for the government, or his work by one way or the other is related to the government, reaches to a very high position in office, or reaches a very high position in their work, generally have an inclination towards politics, will be in philanthropy, relationships will not be very good. They should never have a pet. If they have a pet, that will eventually die. The person is very hardworking, punctual, right? Like he will be lucky after the age of 37, 38. Before that, he will not be very lucky. And there will be strong differences with fathers and other elders. The siblings of mother may support them. The person will be strongly attached to the maternal family, maternal part of the family. It is very good for making money, but for position and authority in life, it is quite a challenging position. Right? The person will have a long face. He will have a prominent physique. In the matter of marriage, as I have already told you, the person will be very unfortunate. The person will be dark complexioned. He will be like angry. He will be easily given to lack of self-control. He will have a very hairy body. Will not be very pleasant to look at. the face will be very good looking, the face will be charming, but the other part of the body will not be that well shaped or that charming, right? The person will be cunning and very bad in speech for the Purva Falguni third pada, right? Understood? Purva Falguni fourth pada. Purva Falguni fourth pada, the person will be high. The person will be highly placed in their profession. But that position where he is highly placed in his profession will come after much struggle. Generally, in the earlier part of life, person does well. Then in the mid of 20s, his progress is checkered. His progress is very much underpinned. So, you know, from 20 to 25, very good progress. 25 to 30, all progress is stopped. Then after 30, once again, good progress. Right? This is indicated. Along with that, the person will be mentally fickle, mentally unstable. Emotionally, he will be, he will not be very good and calm. He will have problems with mother, will not be able to live in his foreign lands. He will have to, change his place either for earning or for studies. Right. Okay. And not very good for wealth. The person will unnecessarily be losing money. He should never make investments. Investing a large amount of money can be very problematic. It will turn into a loss only. Right. And in the later part of life, after crossing 45, the person can be very rich. The person can make good amount of money. And what more? Yeah, the person will be a leader. Many people will follow him. Many people will want to be like him. But his personal life will be filled up with many ups and downs. Person will generally be dissatisfied. He will be workaholic. In profession, he will be very good. Marital life will also be so-so okay type. If he is able to adjust, then marital life will be good. If he is adamant, then marital life will not be good. The real problem will be the emotional self. There will be many people who will stand in his opposition. He will have very strong enemies. And along with having many strong enemies, he will generally be very prone to accidents, very prone to diseases, which comes because of infection, right? Professional life is quite satisfactory after the age of 30. And he will be able to have conveniences. He will be able to make property. He will be able to have every good in life after crossing 30 or 40, if the chart is bad. And before that, the life is quite disturbed. Predictions that I will give. He will be very good in speech. His body will be powerful and well-built. He will be handsome, attractive, will have a good amount of sexual appeal. But he will be undutiful, unfaithful, will be given to cheating. And financial trouble is there, as I have already told you. And the person will be someone who is very good in the art of deceiving others because of his speech. These are the results for the fourth pada of Purva Falguni. Video have been a bit large, but as you know, as Vipulji said, if you have patience, you will be rewarded. If you don't have patience, that is something that I cannot teach. Let's meet in the next class, Uttara Falguni.